19 aprile. 6 casse sono state caricate all'alba. Sono pesanti. Ciascuna di esse contiene una parte di una grossa scultura. 29 aprile. Si metterà a Gibraltar all'alba. La nave ci ha messo ore per approdare nel porto. C'erano molti, molti buchi nel ripostiglio. Ciascuno di essi ha permesso ad enormi quantità d'acqua di entrare. Senza il catrame saremmo affondati in 3 giorni. Abbiamo aperto le casse per gli ufficiali della dogana. Le casse erano vuote.
Received numerous reports regarding a tremendous force that rushed up the rock, which tore down hundreds of trees and created several landslides throughout the previous night. One civilian likened the phenomena to the work of a gigantic crazed fowler. Due to the sheer number of reports and the high level of concern in the surrounding community, I deployed myself along with 13 officers to the rock in search of an explanation. We discovered that there was indeed a newly forged trail through the dense foliage stretching almost the entire height of the rock. The trail was astonishingly linear, with no bends in the path. The cuts to the trees themselves were precise. The downed trees continued to be warm to the touch, presumably due to the extreme speed of this force. A few fires present along the trail were extinguished by fellow officers as we traversed the rock. The path ended at a large crevice in the ground, which looked to be an entrance to a large underground cavern. After requesting additional men and equipment, Officer Hadley descended into the crevice. It was not long until Hadley exclaimed in fright and urged us all to enter. Within the following hour, the majority of us were in the cavern, which appeared to be an undiscovered offshoot of Sir Michael's cave. In the middle of the location stood a plaster model of a tall Greco-Roman statue of a woman. Surrounding this sculpture were the splayed remains of an individual, flattened like a set of clothes. A hollowed-out torso was stretched a quarter of the way up the statue, the sight of which compelled a few of the officers to exit the cavern. The human remains were collected and sent to the morgue, while the sculpture was cleaned and lifted out. The statue's blade, held in its right hand, matched the cuts present on the downed trees. Despite the fantastical implications of this detail, the Gibraltar Police Force officially concludes that the work of the crazed fowler was nothing more than the result of heavy winds. During a secondary investigation, a journal was discovered in the cavern. A translation of its Italian text is in progress.
Arrives the tight-knit wooden ship. The plaster body is absent. Instead, a tall, wounded woman, sleeping in its vessel, donning a helmet wrapped in a robe, clutching a sword and a damaged shield. Overheard a conversation with the captain, a violent conflict with freedom at the port in Gibraltar. They tell me inside her is the plaster. And I walk away, silently believing freedom craved liberation so terribly she tried to take it for herself. But off the ship, she was dragged away. Freedom locked up. Freedom in chains. They tell me I have to take it out of her. So hook, rope, peel and pull. When it was done, freedom stood motionless. Freedom stood still. I see the final bronze woman, and I feel as if, maybe even hope, she's only dormant now, and will awaken again.